October 1st, we launched one of the key provisions of the Affordable Care Act, the new marketplace where people without health insurance, including those who could not afford health insurance and those who were not part of a group plan, could actually go get affordable health care coverage. We know that some consumers are still having difficulty enrolling via the marketplace website, and we are focused on identifying and solving those problems quickly. But it is important to remember that the Affordable Care Act is more than just a website. It has created a new market which allows people access to quality, affordable health insurance options. It does this by pooling consumers into statewide group plans that spread risk between sick people and healthy people, between young and old, and then bargains on their behalf for the best deal on health insurance. By creating competition where there wasn't competition before, insurers are now eager for business, have created new healthcare plans with more choices. The premiums for coverage on the marketplace are lower than expected, and millions of Americans will also qualify for tax credits to make this coverage even more affordable. People will have comprehensive coverage that cannot be taken away, even if they get sick. We know that consumers are eager to purchase this coverage, and I want to assure you that healthcare.gov can and will be fixed quickly, and we are working literally around the clock to make that happen. We have made significant progress in improving the performance and functionality of the website, and we expect the user experience to continue to improve with each passing week. Over the past month, millions of Americans have visited healthcare.gov to look at their new healthcare coverage options under the Affordable Care Act. In that time, nearly 700,000 applications for coverage have been submitted from across the nation, more than half in the federal marketplace alone. This tremendous interest confirms that the American people are looking for quality, affordable healthcare coverage. We know that the initial consumer experience on healthcare.gov has been very frustrating for many Americans. Some have had trouble creating accounts and logging into the site, while others have received confusing error messages or have had to wait for slow page loads or forms that fail to respond in a timely fashion. In the first few days that we went live, few consumers could create an account. We have now resolved that issue. Users can successfully create an account and continue through the full application and enrollment process. We are now able to process nearly 17,000 registrants per hour, or 5 per second, with almost no errors. We've updated the site several times since October 1, fixing bugs and improving the healthcare.gov experience. We've added more capacity and we've doubled the number of servers in order to meet demand. We reconfigured various system components to improve site responsiveness. This has increased performance across the site, but in particular, the viewing and filtering of health plans during the online shopping experience. This now responds in just seconds, whereas it was taking minutes before. We've also resolved issues so that eligibility notices now display properly to consumers at the completion of the application process. Consumers can now view and compare plans without registering for an account. This functionality was not working well in the days leading up to October 1, so we opted to prioritize work on the application process instead. One of our highest priorities was ensuring that consumer information was transmitted correctly to issuers. Over the past week, our team has worked with issuers to resolve outstanding issues, and now all necessary consumer information will be sent to issuers after they've enrolled in the plan of their choice. We will continue to work closely with issuers to identify and solve problems quickly. We've also seen success in improving response time across the website. For the first few weeks, we estimate that users were waiting on average 8 seconds for pages across the site to load. We've now lowered this time to less than 1 second, and we will continue to take aggressive steps to bring response downtime even further. We are pleased with these quick improvements and the parts of the system that are already working well. For example, the Data Hub, the routing tool that provides an efficient and secure way to verify information submitted by consumers, is sending determination to the marketplace in less than 1.2 seconds. The Social Security Administration has reported 4.2 million transactions with the hub, and the IRS has responded to more than 1.3 million requests. When consumers fill out the online application, they can trust that the information they're provided is protected by stringent security standards and that the technology underlying the application process has been tested and is secure. CMS has decades of experience at protecting personal information in Medicare, and we are extending that commitment to the highest security standards for the marketplace. Any system that is this large is inherently risky. We have continued to monitor the security of the system as envisioned in the risk mitigation and compensating control plan and have had no serious issues. Security testing never ends, it will never end, and it will not for this system or for any other large system. While we continue to improve healthcare.gov, it is important to remember that the website is in fact working and more people are applying and enrolling each week. In addition to the website, there are other ways for consumers to approach healthcare.gov. One is they can choose to apply by phone in a 24/7 toll-free number. A customer service representative will work with each consumer to make sure that they can complete the application and enrollment process. Second, people can find in-person help in their communities and work with people trained or certified to help them understand their healthcare options. Third, consumers can fill out a paper application and mail it in. They'll find out whether they're eligible for private insurance, Medicaid, or CHIP, and then they can go online to compare, choose, and enroll in a plan, or they can contact the call center and do it by phone if they prefer. Today, more than 3 out of every 4 Americans get insurance from an employer, from Medicare, from Medicaid, or from the VA system. Americans who purchase insurance on their own, however, generally buy coverage on the individual market. Before the Affordable Care Act, coverage in the individual market often was unaffordable, had high copays or deductibles, or lacked basic benefits like maternity care, mental health services, and prescription drug coverage. These plans also had high turnover rates, greater than 50% per year frequently, and often were not renewed at the end of a plan year. The healthcare law is creating new protections for people in the individual market, as well as strengthening employer-based coverage. In the health insurance marketplace, consumers will no longer be charged more because of their gender or pre-existing condition. Recommended preventive services will be covered at no additional out-of-pocket cost. There will be caps on out-of-pocket cost, and plans will have to offer a basic package of 10 essential benefits. Plans that were in place before the Affordable Care Act passed and have not been changed in ways that substantially cut benefits or increase cost sharing are grandfathered in and are exempt from offering most of the new consumer protections. They must notify their enrollees that they are grandfathered plans, however, and for these enrollees, nothing has to change in 2014. Some of the 5% of Americans who currently get insurance on the individual market have recently received notices from their insurance companies suggesting that their plans will no longer exist. These Americans do have a choice. They can choose a different plan being offered by their insurer, or they can shop for coverage in the marketplace or outside the marketplace. As insurers have made clear, they are not dropping consumers. They're improving their coverage options, often offering better value plans with additional benefits. Indeed, the majority of people in the individual market today will qualify for discounted or free healthcare coverage when signing up for coverage through the marketplace. One study found that, not counting the 1 million who qualify for Medicaid, 48% of people who buy insurance through the individual market will have a tax credit that averages over $5,500. The Affordable Care Act is almost 4 years old now, and during its time, we have seen many improvements in our healthcare system, Medicare, Medicaid, Medicare Advantage. The opening of the marketplace on October 1 is the latest step in the implementation of the law, and we acknowledge that we have a lot more to do, and we're ready to do it. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Commissioner Tavenner.